When I was just a bouncing baby boy creature, I watched a lot of television. Cable at my grandparents', stolen satellite on my father's criminal farm. I perused the outdoors when forced or when video games turned into a chore, but the comforting glow of the electric babysitter always whisked me away when it so fancied. And it fancied a lot. I would almost call myself an expert on commercials, but I need that plausible deniability safety net. So let's just say I'm a commercial veteran of the corporate wars instead. Although that may imply stolen valor, so I guess we'll just keep it at the professional level of someone who's seen a TV sometimes. Today is a blast through the past. I wanted to look at some commercials that may still be stuck in your head. Because they sure as shit are stuck in mine. If you grew up during the 90s and the early to mid-2000s, these little ditties made an itty-bitty dent in the itty-bitty-ditty processor that's lodged firmly between the "me want ice cream" and "there is no ethical consumption under capitalism" parts of your brain. So let's take a look and review these commercials that are firmly lodged in my brain and see if we can wake something up in that empty skull of yours. Hey! I'll even use silly little numbers to denote which ones I like and which ones I wish were out of my head. Bumpets. Something easy to start our commercial cavalcade with. Bumpets were a product that made your hair bump up. The way that this bit of plastic made your head look fat and engorged always stuck with me in a way that I never thought possible. It lays dormant in the endless narrow passageways of the mind. And now that you remember, you'll soon forget. 1 out of 10. Moon shoes. Listen, as an adult, I still want a pair of moon shoes. I mean, I would if they worked the way that they were advertised, but we all know that moon shoes were a lie, just like the moon landing. And if one of your rich friends did end up scoring a pair, they pretended they didn't, so that they wouldn't have to worry about ruining the mystery behind them. The song was okay, 4 out of 10. The deflated weed commercial. I'm a bit too young for the "egg is brains" commercial, but I do remember the one where if you smoke weed, you deflate like a balloon, and your stretchy skin sack just lays all around the house. I was terrified of weed as a kid, because I didn't want to be some organ-lacking skin monster. But now I know that weed just makes you hungry and get really good naps. 2 out of 10. J.G. Wentworth. This opera is perfectly embedded into my psyche. Someone I don't know could just say the word "if" at the right note, and I know that if they need cash now, who they need to call. A perfect example of an earworm, and I'll probably be singing this song until I die. Call now. 10 out of 10. Quiznos rats. Hate. Let me tell you how much I hate the Quiznos rats since I began to live. There are 100 billion brain cells that fill my skull. If the word "hate" was engraved on each nanoangstrom of these hundreds of billions of cells, it would not equal 1/1 billionth of the hate I feel for the Quiznos rats at this micro instant. Hate. Hate. 8 out of 10. Chef Boyardee Rolling Ravioli. The craziest thing about the Rolling Ravioli commercials is how often I find myself whistling the little tune nestled inside of it. Also, sometimes I worry about how many cans of ravioli are slowly yet inexorably marching towards me, and one day I'll wake up completely submerged in a sea of finely aged ravioli wine. 6 out of 10. ShamWow. Definitely have not forgot about this guy or the altercation that almost left him tongueless in Florida. Whether it was the ShamWow or the Slap Chop, whatever this guy was selling, people were buying. Crazy how much the scout from Team Fortress 2 gets around, huh? Are you gonna love his nuts? 4 out of 10. Billy Mays. Be it OxyClean, Zorbies, Grap-It, Kaboom, or the Big City Slider Station, Billy Mays was the infomercial guy. With so many commercials under his umbrella, you would be hard-pressed to grow up in the 2000s without seeing this bearded king. Sadly, after passing away in 2009, a door was closed in the world of infomercials. Billy Mays almost made it a treat to watch television after the regularly scheduled programming was off the air, and his presence has left a hole that not even Mighty Putty can fix. 10 out of 10. Esurance ads. There's a reason that you remember the Esurance ads. I'm not gonna ask to see your browser history, but I know why you bought all that insurance, even when you didn't need it. And you and I know there's an avalanche of people that had a crush on Aaron Esurance. It's okay. It happens. 6 out of 10. PSP nut commercial. I'm still confused. Am I supposed to be playing nuts inside? I can play with nuts outside, but was this a ball joke? Is a PSP like my balls I can play outside, or an actual physical nut? Is Sony telling me to play with nuts outside, or that the PSP is nuts? Is the PSP my balls? 9 out of 10. Axe chocolate commercial. Oh, I had a few nightmares related to this commercial. I mean, Axe already kind of sucks, and the idea that wearing spray deodorant would drive the opposite sex to assault and eat me wasn't something I needed rattling around in my pre-adolescent mind. I mean, there's a few things wrong with this commercial, but as a kid, I was hyper-fixated by this idea that if I used Axe, I would be consumed. I'm a consumer, dammit. I'm supposed to be the one to consume. 4 out of 10. Gerber Life Grow-Up Plan. I barely remember this one. They wanted you to give them money as insurance that if your kid died, have life insurance or something. It tickles the nerve center of my brain, but it doesn't have a sick or catchy tune. 1 out of 10. Crazy Craving. If I didn't include him, I'd get some comments, but I already went into full details on my worst cereal mascot video. So go watch that if you wanted a dedicated deep dive into the world of crazy cravings. 3 out of 10. Blockbuster's No More Late Fees ad. I remember when this happened, and everyone rejoiced. Rejoiced that this was the end of Blockbuster, and thank God it's dead. Listen, I miss the nostalgia of renting movies, but I do not miss all the random dings and charges that rental stores would add, and I was less worried about late fees and more worried about the employees behind the counter with thousand-yard stares. Now that I've done my time in retail, I understand. It's not your fault. 2 out of 10. Floam. What's squishy, stretchy, and lets you cover your toys in crud so that they're nigh unwashable? Floam! See, I didn't want to buy this for my toys. I wanted to mold my own set of Floam armor, and I would terrorize the neighborhood. I mean, not a good idea. But I did once try to hot glue magnets to my hands and head in an effort to climb the refrigerator, so I wasn't the brightest light bulb in the sock drawer. 3 out of 10. Capri Sun Disrespectoids. You better believe I would pop every Capri Sun that I could. I would disrespect so many of these pouches to try to trigger some magical transformation that would turn me into sand, or I could have a giant bobblehead. Alas, it didn't work. You can disrespect the pouch as much as you want, and it won't fight back. And now I can only faintly recall the memories. 5 out of 10. The Drake Sprite commercial. Why? Why does Drake open up? Why? How is Drake turning into a robot made from leftover vinyl record players and random mismatched audio equipment going to sell me on Sprite? It's not the most horrifying thing that sold me a soda before, but it sure as hell made me back off from Sprite for a few years. I don't want to see what I'm made of. If I drink a Sprite, sacks and sacks of garbage are gonna fall out, and I'd have to spend the whole day cleaning my psyche off of the floor. 2 out of 10. Band-Aid's Stuck on Me song. I have this song stuck in my head, and now it's stuck in yours. Effective advertising is something as simple as this. A catchy song is all you need, advertisers. Now please stop making more and more horrifying commercials to try to permeate the cultural zeitgeist with how wacky and zany your commercials are. 9 out of 10. Mountain Dew's Puppy Monkey Baby. Speaking of horrible commercials to penetrate the inner eye of pop culture, this commercial is hell. I know that I said late 90s and early 2000s, but this Mountain Dew commercial from 2016 is seared underneath my eyelids. Something in the early 2010s in advertising must have snapped. Because while most of the wacky commercials that have been produced in the last 10 years have just piled up into a hell katamari, this one stands alone as evidence that there is no God. If there was a God, they would have stopped this. 0 out of 10, but 10 out of 10 for not leaving my head! McDonald's Filet of Fish song. My grandfather, Kevin, had a Billy the Big Mouth Bass singing fish on his wall, but it would only sing Don't Worry, Be Happy. I wish that he had a fish that would sing about sandwiches. I want a fish that sings about sandwiches. We all want a fish that sings about sandwiches. I would feel bad for it, but the McDonald's filet of fish is like 90% sawdust, so I don't know why he's upset. 6 out of 10. Bacon strips commercial. I ate one of these. They don't taste like bacon. They taste like dry dog treats. Don't eat these. I will remember the dog, though. How could I not remember the dog? 7 out of 10. Canine Advantix song. I still find myself humming this tune every odd moment or so. For some reason, commercials that sound like an old camp song tend to stick more easily in my head. Maybe I like camping. Maybe I have fleas. Who knows? It's there. But there probably ain't no bugs on me. They're probably not. Now I'm itching. This sucks. 8 out of 10. The Education Connection song. I would wake up to this song because every once in a while it would play on Adult Swim. And I was one of those high schoolers who had their television on while they slept. This song and the mom from Home Movies yelling Brendan were surefire ways to wake me up 4 to 5 hours before I needed to get to the bus. Also, did this work or was this a scam? Half of these college commercials always felt pretty scammy to me. 4 out of 10. Cocoa Puffs. Were you loco, or coco, or cuckoo, or crazy for Cocoa Puffs? Are you inclined to commit crimes for chocolate bird cereal? While there was the Trix Rabbit or the Cookie Crisps Wolf, the Cocoa Puffs bird was my brain food of choice. There are a lot of cereal mascots, and this one didn't haunt my dreams or make me question how I felt about muscular tigers. This bird was just so damn hungry. 7 out of 10. Baby Bottle Pop Baby Commercial. Baby Bottle Pop Baby Commercial. There's also the Jonas Brothers commercial, but the Baby Bottle Pop song itself has been around for a while. I'll always remember this one. This one involving age regression and head-twisting horror. If your bottle candy allegedly turns me into a baby, I'm allegedly pursuing legal action. I do not want to be a baby. 3 out of 10. Oral-B brush-ups. Rip-off. Con. Scam. These did not work. You'd see toothbrush replacers for the busy American in stores constantly. And none of them ever did better at hiding bad breath than just good old-fashioned gum, or maybe just actually brushing your teeth. Don't you dare think I don't know. Go brush your teeth now. The song is in fact a bop though, so it scores points for that, even though the product is a dental lie, a flossing fib. 5 out of 10. Geico, sexy grandpa time. This will be the only Geico commercial I have in here. There are a bunch, but I don't want to oversaturate this video with Geico representation. I think that it took a lot longer than 15 minutes to make this commercial. And I also think that you should take more than 15 minutes to figure out what car insurance works best for you. I mean, are you going to get car insurance based on sexy grandpa time? I trust the caveman more. Bring back the caveman. Never do sexy grandpa time again. 4 out of 10. FreeCreditReport.com song. Love this commercial. Love the song. Too bad the guy is from Quebec. Or Quebec? Quebec? I'm wary around French Canadians. They're terrible at video games. 7 out of 10. Head on. Once when I was a kid, I swear this commercial played 3 times in a row for a week straight, every single time our local station cut to commercial. It's almost like somebody wanted to torture the airwaves with non-stop pain. Which you would need Head On for. If you ever listen to this more than once, and once you hear it, it never goes away. It's like a lawn dart thrown directly at your mind. 9 out of 10 for longevity. M&M Christmas commercial. I haven't had cable in quite a while, so I don't know if they still somehow run this one, but it's the only Christmas commercial that I can verifiably recite whenever it turns on. Everything else is jumbled in the holly and the jolly, but this commercial exists. It just exists. 10 out of 10. Shirley Temple, VHS or DVD collection. Back before Discord, but post TeamSpeak in the days of Skype, I would constantly torture a friend of mine by just simply saying, "Animal crackers in my soup, monkeys and rabbits loop the loop." Sometimes you'd get a sigh, sometimes you'd get an immediate disconnect, but the fun of torturing your friends lasts forever. Thank you, Shirley Temple. 8 out of 10. Cheetos Orange Underground commercials. I've talked about this before on podcasts, but back when I was a kid, Cheetos used to run these ads about the elusive and secretive Orange Underground. Chester the Cheetah would ask you to cause mischief and mayhem for his orange powdery corn puffs, and they even had a YouTube channel. The cool thing is, if you were one of the first subscribers to this YouTube channel, you won a year's supply of Cheetos and what they called a unification bowl because sports or something. I was one of the first subscribers. I won and have that bowl to this day. I will say that the year's supply of Cheetos was just a manufacturer's coupon for one bag of Cheetos, but it's the only time I ever won something, and even if I felt gypped, I have a glass bowl from Frito-Lay's that other people don't. And that's kind of neat. 7 out of 10. Chia Pet. Oh yeah, I'm the guy yelling ch-ch-ch-chia in the shower. And oh yeah, I'm not gonna stop. I always wondered if you were bald and put chia seeds on your scalp, would you grow funny bush hair on your head? Grass Bob Ross style? 5 out of 10. Soccer boppers. Okay, so there were soccer boppers and sock'em boppers, but they had the same theme, so what came first? I always remember them as sock'em boppers, but I guess Mattel thought that it infringed on their rights to rock 'em sock 'em robots? Now in 2021, are they soccer boppers or do I sock them boppers? I don't know. How do I know what's more fun than a pillow fight? Will someone please tell me? 8 out of 10. Rainbow art. If you were the quiet, rich kid whose parents were divorcing and trying to buy your love, you probably owned some rainbow art brushes. You'd color your cares away while looking out the rainy window, wondering if Dad was ever going to come and pick you up for the weekend. I, the resident poor kid, would have to make do with melting my dollar store crayons into a wax brick, while I wondered in awe what kind of life would be the life of a child whose parents would buy things for them off of television. What kind of life indeed? 3 out of 10. Sarah McLachlan's animal commercials. No commercial in the history of commercials has made me cry but one. This commercial made me cry. I can watch someone getting dramatically shot or ripped in half in a movie, even if it's a character I care about, but the cat dying in the movie Eight-Legged Freaks will make me cry. You better believe that if I had money, I would have given money to Sarah McLachlan, no problem. I love those animals. 10 out of 10. Zoo books. All right, I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. For too long, the wealthy have flaunted the fact that they have the tiger posters. For too long, they have been able to afford to spend $20 on 12 issues of zoo books. $20 in 90s and early 2000s money, mind you, with the included tiger poster. No more. No more. You can buy the tiger poster on Redbubble for like 15 bucks. Go. Seize the means of production. The key to wealth and happiness has to be the tiger poster. 8 out of 10. The original Chocolate Factory. The commercial for this is barely memorable for me, but I do remember my grandma buying it and me sneaking into it to eat the raw chocolate discs that came with it. I love those chocolate discs. It might have been this or a random chocolate fondue kit. 2 out of 10. Campbell's Snowmen commercial. Yeah, I mean, leave your kid outside to play and all that, but soup isn't gonna fix their frostbitten extremities. You need a doctor. The doctor can be named Soup. 5 out of 10. Orbit's Dirty Mouth. For every moment I had to suffer with the wacky and zany kid saying, "What the French toast?" the Orbit's marketing team should suffer 1 year in hell. Maybe this one was more localized for me, considering that there was a kid attending my school who wouldn't stop saying, "What the French toast?" So this might be a personalized mimetic hazard. 3 out of 10. Kool-Aid Man. Step into the Kool-Aid dimension. Step inside and experience a short wormhole trip to the beach. The Kool-Aid Man is not just a tool of destruction. In my eyes, the Kool-Aid Man aids creation. The Kool-Aid Man is the Alpha and the Omega, the Oh Yeah and the End. 8 out of 10. Menards. Menards is a hardware and home furnishing store that also has a grocery section. As an Iowan, I've been exposed to this song so many times that it might actually be a part of my DNA. If I got hit on the head with a coconut and got cartoon amnesia, this would be one of the few things that would somehow inexplicably remain. 10 out of 10. I have to. The Coca-Cola Polar Bears. Somehow all I remember about the Coca-Cola Bears was worrying about their dental health. Too much soda will ruin your teeth. You gotta take care of those bear teeth. 6 out of 10. The General. Hate this dude. He's smug. And he's hanging out with Shaq now like he's hot stuff. I've seen better computer animated graphics on drag and drop GeoCities assets. Hate this guy and his car insurance. 2 out of 10. Liberty Mutual's Wilford Brimley commercials. I have fond memories of watching television with my grandpa Gary, and on the old person channels he liked to watch, this would come up quite often. I didn't know who Wilford Brimley was, but I was damn well sure that he had diabetes. My grandfather also had diabetes. This is relatable to me as a consumer. 9 out of 10. Dancing Six Flags Man. Something about their stretched, sallow skin and not knowing when the Venga bus was coming to take me away with its eternal reaper behind the wheel made me terrified. Six Flags might have been the destination for some, but for me, I always feared what dark torments awaited if one was to stay on the bus. Would the party continue forever in perpetuity? Is the Venga bus always coming? 6 out of 10. Berries and Cream Starburst commercials. Now this is what I'm talking about. This is the commercial that made me a social pariah during my freshman year of high school, because I just couldn't stop doing the berries and cream, berries and cream, I'm a little boy who loves berries and cream bit. No one thought it was funny. Not a single soul. I still love this commercial, though, even if it is partially responsible for casting me down the social ladder. But I mean, it was probably more that I was a grade-A weird kid. 10 out of 10. Zoo Pals. When you clean your plate and you see their face, you know you've done a good job. The jingle that will always drive me to make sure that even if I have a plate with no face, that I eat everything there. I mean, I'm lying. I was a picky kid, and my mom was definitely not spending the extra dollar or so on the fancy animal plates. But imagine my palate if she had. The places I could have gone. 5 out of 10. I'm a Mac and I'm a PC. I didn't really know what a Mac was besides using one as a StarCraft machine for a small portion of my childhood, but I knew that in my heart of hearts that I trusted the guy with the glasses more. Something about the sheer incompetence portrayed endeared me towards that PC man. He was trying his best, and look who's the gamer now. 7 out of 10. Applejacks. Unlike Apple computers, I always felt bad for the Apple cereal man. I mean, if I was going to bite directly into something, I would choose an apple over a cinnamon stick. I loved a lot of the old stop-motion animations that commercials would use, but these are the ones that are stuck in my head. A rivalry. Aged like fine wine. 9 out of 10. Elephant the elephant. I never wanted to see this elephant blow. I always thought about putting different things in the elephant, like spaghetti. Would Elephant the Elephant blow out spaghetti? Unlikely. The tube would be too long, and it's a fabric tube, so I don't think it would work. 7 out of 10. The Wii would like to play commercials. I would love it if two dudes came into my house just to play some Wii. I mean, do the families get to keep the Wii afterward? They're probably all actors, but I like to dream that I would get a free Wii and play bowling with some cool guys, instead of playing on my old Xbox 360 that was wrapped up in a towel. I would like to play. 7 out of 10. Reese's Puffs. I mean, this is the king of cereal jingles. The cream of the crop. The top dog of the cereal jingle world. Reese's Puffs will make you dance, and it will run through your head at least 10 times before your day is over. And you want to know something? I think this is one of the only earworms that I don't mind getting stuck in my head. It's comforting to know that Reese's Puffs is there. Also, a quick anecdote for you. When I worked at GameStop, they were giving away these small boxes of Reese's Puffs for some video game, and I ended up taking two big boxes of the small boxes home, and I ate cereal for like 2 weeks, and I would still eat Reese's Puffs. Thank you, Reese's Puffs. 10 out of 10. Subway's $5 footlong commercials. This is bullshit. Because of the way Subway is franchised, not every Subway would offer $5 footlongs. I mean, it's a better promotion than the one they had, and it didn't have that guy that did the bad things, but still, my local Subway didn't offer these. I had to go to the big city Subway for cheaper sandwiches, and I hated the big city Subway. 4 out of 10. The mesothelioma commercial. If you or a loved one has seen this commercial more than once, then chances are that you can't get it out of your head. I don't even know what mesothelioma is without using Google, but I sure as hell remember how to pronounce it and how to spell it. 6 out of 10. The Mucinex commercials. This jiggly green dude popped up all over the television, and something is inherently disgusting about a talking booger. I used to have Osmosis Jones-styled fantasies about a small team of specialists going up into my body to exorcise this green demon. 4 out of 10. Time Life's Ultimate Love Song Collection. A bunch of these music collection commercials rolled around the old boob tube, and this is probably the big one that is stuck inside my boobed skull. I mean, there was Now That's What I Call Music and Kids Bop, but I've repressed those to the point of no return, and I'm a better man for it. 5 out of 10. Mr. T's Warcraft commercial. Knight, elf, mohawk! I would not remember this commercial if one of my classmates in high school didn't stop quoting it. It was funny the first time, but after about the 200th time, I think that not only World of Warcraft was ruined for me, but also Mr. T. If that guy is still running around quoting this commercial, I pity him. 3 out of 10. Lego My Ego. The puppet Lego My Ego commercial is the only one that really permeates my brain fog. I'm sure I've seen every Lego My Ego commercial in existence, but the puppet pretzel pops up in my noggin every now and then. 3 out of 10. Five Gum. Do you know how it feels to chew five gum? Do you remember that video that used to circulate all around on the internet? You know the one. 9 out of 10. The Post-it Note Weed Dog. Listen, if deflation wasn't going to get your kids to stop smoking weed, then telling them that dogs would be disappointed in them probably won't work either. I mean, is the dude hearing the dog because of the weed? If I smoke weed, do I get to listen to a talking dog? So I should smoke weed, right? Even if the talking dog is disappointed in me, it's still a talking dog. 7 out of 10. The Old Spice Man commercial. Hello, viewers. Look at your wall. Now back to me. Now back to your wall. Now back to me. This is the commercial that made me who I am. Which sounds ridiculous, but it's also sort of responsible for the hell renaissance of advertising. But I have a weirdly personal attachment to this commercial. This released when I was in high school, and I was just figuring out I could say things really good sometimes. I memorized this commercial, and it scored me my first date. It was a neat party trick to pull out, and might be the sole reason I do YouTube in the first place. For once, one of my brain cells had fired in the right direction, and I blame this commercial for making me want to say things in a funny voice online for random people. So, thank you, Old Spice Man. I mean, thank you from me, but I'm still kind of miffed that you helped push advertising in a weird direction. 10 out of 10. Wow, hey, you really sat down and watched a man talk about commercials, huh? Well, now it's time to let me know what commercials are permanently seared in your brain, and what ones you might think should have been on this video. Hope you enjoyed this fond look back into the consumerism nightmarescape. Thank you for watching. Please check out my other videos. They're also things. I have a Patreon you can check out, and I'm often streaming over on twitch.tv/Prendaniel. If you really think about it, the end of this video is a commercial, but for me, consider subscribing, maybe, I don't know, if you like the video, leave a silly little comment, leave a cute little face. I'm gonna go now. Bye.